perfectly inelastic demand. First, so my dear student, my next topic is degrees of elastic demand or types of elastic demand, kinds of elastic demand you can also say. So first topic I am going to start on perfectly elastic demand. So according to this perfectly elastic demand, alright, we can state that it is a situation, it refers to a situation in which price changes. I am writing in short, price changes. P means price. Price changes as and demand remains same. Here PED is 0. Here PED is equal to 0. Price elastic demand or elastic demand is 0. Right? Law of demand does not apply here. Law of demand does not apply here. Law of demand does not apply here. Right? See, my dear student, so we can prove it with the help of table and diagram. Suppose I am taking, I am taking one table I am also making, price, demand, units, price, rupees, units, price is 4, demand is 4, price is 2, demand is 4, price become 4, demand remains 4, price become 10, demand remains 4. So, now, see, the same thing we can plot in the diagram. Diagram states, now see here, demand is fixed. Demand is fixed. Demand is fixed here. E1, E2, all the price is rising. Y-axis, X-axis, price is rising. Demand is fixing. Whatever may be the price, right? Demand will not change. It means the nature of the commodity is urgent, emergency, food, medicine, clothes, house, etc. Right. So, my dear student, this is called perfectly elastic demand. Perfectly elastic demand means it is a situation in which price changes. Changes means it may be rise or fall. Rise, if it is rises, then till then demand will remain same. If it falls, till then demand will remain same. We can show both sides. I have shown on one side, only one thing, rising portion I have shown. But you can show also the decreasing portion of the price. Right, see, in the same diagram. Right, see, so this is, you know, called as, you know, perfectly inelastic demand. Right, second part is, you know, perfectly elastic demand. It refers to a situation in which price remain fixed only demand can change up to any extent. Only demand is changing. Here it is opposite of perfectly inelastic demand. Its meaning is, you know, now perfectly inelastic demand has its opposite, perfectly elastic demand. It's an opposite. Here PD, you know, is infinite, not zero, infinite. In this case, only price is fixed. Price will remain fixed, but only demand will increase, may increase or decrease. We can show it again with the table and diagram. Price, demand, right? Again, units, rupees. Price 2, demand 4, price 2, demand becomes 10. Right, see, demand can increase or decrease up to an extent. Decreasing part I have not shown here, I have shown only the increasing part. There are very less chances when the demand decreases. Right, so this is price, that is 2. Price. X. 4. It becomes 10. PD is equal to infinity. Demand can increase up to any extent. Right? It may become 0. It may also become 0. It may also become 1. It may also become 20, it may also become lakh, right? But price will not change. And price will not be followed. So whether demand becomes 0 or demand becomes, you know, infinite. Price, demand rises to 1 unit or 10 units, 20 units, 50 units. But price will remain fixed. So this is a case of perfectly elastic demand, right? So my dear student, you know, this is another exception of law of demand. Here law of demand does not apply here. Law of demand does not apply here. So my dear student, this is the most important thing to understand you both the cases, right? Only there is a difference is of in. This is the difference between two, but the C, the changes is numerous. Definition, meaning is totally changed. The next part is unitary elastic demand. Unitary elastic demand, I will discuss with you. Unitary elastic demand, that is the third. Now it refers to a situation in which percentage change in price brings same percentage change in demand. Its meaning is that here PD is equal to 1, right? Law of demand applies here. Right. Its meaning is that if there is change, if the price changes by 10%, demand will also changes by 10%. If the price is changed by 20%, the demand will change also by the 20%. So it is called unitary elastic demand or equal elastic demand. We call it unitary elastic demand or equal elastic demand. In this case, if the price is changed by 2%, right, and this curve makes rectangular hyperbola also. This curve makes rectangular hyperbola also, right? So it means, what is the meaning of rectangular hyperbola? The all the squares or rectangles made by the curve is are same. Both the all these rectangles are same. We can prove it with the help of one table and diagram. We can prove it with the help of one table and diagram. That is price. I am showing one case only. That is fall. Price. Initially price was 4. Demand was 4. As price falls to 2, demand becomes 8. Same percentage, right? There is a 50% fall in price and the demand is also risen by 50%. So this is called unitary elastic demand or equal elastic demand. Right? So in this case, you can see DD is the demand curve, right? It is sloping downward. You know, my dear, now the price, initially price was rupees 4, right? As price falls to, and demand was, sorry, initially price was rupees 4, demand was 4 unit. As suddenly price falls to rupees 2, demand becomes 8. So there is 50% rise in the demand. All the three squares, or you can say rectangle, will remain same. Remember this, right? Because this curve makes rectangular hyperbola. As much as change in demand will, as much as change in price will come, the same percentage will occur in the demand also. The next part is fourth one, that is right, more elastic demand, more elastic demand, right, my dear student, this more elastic demand means it refers to a situation in which price changes in less percentage, but percentage change in demand is is more. Here P is always greater than 1. In this case, percentage change in price is less. Right? Maybe 5, we can assume 5%. But percentage change in demand is 20%. Right? So in this case, you know, my dear student, percentage change in demand will come more. Therefore, it is called more elastic demand. It is called as more elastic demand. We can prove it with the help of one table and diagram. Now, we can prove it with the help of table and diagram. Now see, percentage change in price is less, but percentage change in demand is more in this case. So, my dear student, this is the case of more elastic demand, right, or highly elastic demand, right, we can also call it, you know, according to table and diagram, right, initial price is rupees 4 and demand is only 4 million, right. As a price falls to rupees 2, demand becomes 12 unit. So here you see the change in price is 50% and change in demand is more than 50%. That is, you can say it is a more than 50%. That is more than, it is 100% demand is changed. So this is a case of highly elastic demand or more elastic demand. This was my fourth case. Then, my dear student, there is a last case also. We can prove it. That is called less elastic demand. That is less elastic demand or relatively less elastic demand. That is my fifth point. Less elastic demand and highly elastic demand, right? In this case, it refers to a situation in which price changes. Right. The last part of the degree of elastic demand, right, is less elastic demand. According to my dear student, you know, less elastic demand, it refers to a situation in which change in price is more. Now here price is changed more, but the change in demand is very less. Same thing is represented in the diagram. See here, demand price was initially rupees 2 and demand was 4 rupees. As price changed to increase to 6 rupees, demand falls, but fall in demand is very less, that is 1 unit. 3. Right, see, the same thing is shown in the diagram. Now see, the demand curve is, you know, less elastic. Demand is changed, but demand, change in demand is less than, PD is less than 1. PD is less than 1 here. So my dear student, we can say, according to table and diagram, initial price was 6, initial price was 2, demand was 4. As price rises to 6 rupees, demand becomes 3. So demand is shifted back, but shift in demand is very less. This is the case of less elastic demand. Law of demand applies here, right, also. But, you know, my dear student, the percentage change in demand is very less as compared to the percentage change in price. Thank you, my dear student. This is the topic of chapter 5 is completed.